Next is stepper motor. Stepper motor is an electromechanical device which generates discrete rotations. So when we apply DC electrical signal, these stepper motors are generating discrete signal. It differs from normal DC motors, because normal DC motor, it generates continuous rotations when we apply DC signal, but here we will get discrete signal which is not continuous. As stepper motors are widely used in industrial embedded applications and electronic consumer electronic devices, robotics, and one of the major application in daylight which we see daily, the paper feed mechanism of printer and fax machines. These machines are using the stepper motor for the functioning. And in stepper motor, based on the coil winding arrangement, the two-phase stepper motor is classified into two: unipolar and bipolar. Unipolar stepper motor and bipolar stepper motor. In unipolar stepper motor is having two windings per phase, but bipolar stepper motor is having single winding per phase. And same way, there are three different stepping modes in stepper motor. They are full step mode, wave step mode, half step mode. In full step mode stepper motor, both the phases are energized simultaneously. We have two phases, both the phases are energized simultaneously. Actually, there will be four coils. The coils are named as A, B, C, D. Out of these four, two adjacent coils will be energized. So these coils, step by step, it will take care of the rotations. Here we can see, in the first step, coil A and B are energized. In the second step, coil B and C are energized. In the third one, C and D are energized. And in the fourth one, D and A are energized. We have to note here, all the two coils are adjacent. So here, adjacent two coils will be energized, which makes the rotation. Next one, wave step mode. In wave step mode, only one phase is energized at a time. Only one phase. But in full step mode, two phases are energized. But here, only one phase is energized at a time. And the coils of that particular phase will be energized alternatively. For example, here we can say, in step 1, coil A is energized. In step 2, coil B is energized. 3, C is energized. 4, D is energized. So alternately, it is, so after D, again it goes to A, B, C, D. It will continue. So each coil is responsible for the rotation. Third one, half step mode. In half step mode, it is a combination of both wave step mode and full step mode. Means in the first step, it is acting as wave step mode, and in the second step, it is acting as full step mode. Here we can see the example which I have given. In the step 1, coil A is energized, means now this is in wave step mode. In the second step, coil A and B both are energized, means it is in full step mode. Again, we have wave step mode, B is energized. Then in 4, B and C are energized. Then C is energized. Then C and D are energized. Then D is energized. Then again D and E are energized. So this is, here we can, based on this we can tell it is a combination of full step mode and half step mode. So in the, we have to note the first is wave, then full step mode. Next one which we are going to see is push button switch. It is an input device. It is a basic device. It will be there in all the embedded system almost. It comes in two configurations, namely push to make and push to break. There are two configurations, push to make, push to break. In the first configuration, push to make configuration, the switch is normally in open state. And it makes the circuit contact when we press the switch. When we press the switch, it makes the circuit contact. Then in second case, push to break configuration, the switch is normally in closed state and it breaks the circuit contact when the switch is pressed. In embedded system, push button switches, which can be used as start button, reset button, and pulse generator. Then all the push button switches will be connected with port of the embedded system's processor or controller. And depending on the way in which push button interface to the controller, depending on the way the push button is interfaced to the controller, it can generate either a high pulse or low pulse. In the first figure, it is generating low pulse. In both the cases, switch is open only, but depending on the port pin, it is the first one is generating low pulse and the second one is generating high pulse. And the last one is keyboard. Keyboard is also a input device for the user interface. If the number of key required is less limited, then we can go with the push button switch. These push button switches will be connected with the ports. As I said earlier, these push buttons will be connected with the port. But there are some situations where we need more number of keys, for the user to interface with the embedded device. So the input devices are nothing but where we can communicate with the embedded system. So this is the interfacing devices between user and embedded system. So wherever we need more number of keys to interface, we cannot go with the push button, because push button should be connected with the port. If the keys are more, all the keys cannot be connected with the ports of the processor or controller, because we have limited number of ports pins in processor and controller. So due to this limitation, we should go for the keyboard, matrix keyboard. So this is the diagram for matrix keyboard. Thank you.